Make it rain. Welcome to 50 and 50 to 50. I'm Doug Fitzgerald. Thank you so much for joining me. I look forward to spending the next few minutes with you. And if we don't know each other yet, I look forward to getting to know you better over the next several days, weeks, months, and hopefully years to come. Now, what I'm doing is creating 50 episodes in 50 days leading up to my 50th birthday. And I'm just having a great time sharing stories, life lessons, and tips that I've learned along the way over my past 49 plus years that have added true value in my life. And I hope that they can add some value to your life as well. Now, we are on the home stretch. We only have 5 episodes left, and I'm super excited about these next 5, so watch them every day. And if you haven't had a chance to watch our previous ones, I highly recommend it. Just go back, watch some of those videos. We've got some great stories, tips, I think that can be real helpful to you. And pass those along to other people if you think it would be helpful to them as well. Now, my thought for today is this. Make it rain. I'm excited about this episode. You know, sprinkled throughout the 50 episodes, I've been walking you through some basic money management tips that have radically transformed my life, Tammy's life, and my family's life. And it's so fun for me to share these with people and watch them implement these principles because it can change your life as well. In episode 14, we looked at your total income and expenses. In episode 20, we established your current net worth. In episode 26, we found extra income that you have by tightening up your expenses. And remember, with this extra income, we are establishing an emergency account, we're paying off debt, we're setting aside 3 to 6 months of living expenses, and then ultimately beginning to invest in, with a little hint here, make it rain, all right? In episode 34, we walked you through a proven plan to eliminate your debt. In episode 40, I gave you a surefire way to stop worrying about money for good by showing you how to save up 3 to 6 months worth of your living expenses. So today, I'm going to show you how you can make it rain cash in your life. And this is the fun part of all of this. I'm telling you, some people don't like to handle money, manage money, and all that, because they just don't know what to do. But I'm telling you, once you learn how to do it, it gets more and more exciting, because then you get to this point in your life when you've done everything else, you get to make it rain. You get to tell your money what to do in powerful ways that can help you, your family, and those around you. Now, remember what I always tell you. You know, money management is very simple. It's all about discipline. And if you can harness it correctly, it can be really exciting. But I always tell my family, my friends, people around me, people I work with this. Tell your money what to do. Don't let your money tell you what to do. When you tell your money what to do, it can be exciting. If you let your money tell you what to do, it's literally a prison that can destroy you and your family and those around you. And I don't want that to happen. So now that you've paid off your debt, you simply take all that excess money and those excess funds, and you get to start investing it, using it in powerful ways. I highly recommend that you find a trusted financial and investment advisor who can help you identify your financial goals and then help you get there. Somebody who is going to be truly involved in knowing what you want to achieve, where you want to get to, and by when, and they can give you a good, clear, easy to understand plan to help you get to that point. Now, personally, I think it's a good idea if you find someone who is paid based off of the income that they generate for you. Why? Because then they have their skin in the game. So there are a lot of kinds of people out there, investment people out there. I just say, be very careful. Go to people that you trust, ask for recommendations, and find people that are really going to help you get to you where you want to go. Now, here's my ultimate money philosophy. It's always this. I tell my family this, people around me this. It's this. It's my goal to be worth more next month than I am this month. Did you hear that? I have a plan and a system that I'm always monitoring throughout the month, and I want to be worth more next month than I am this month. And that's what good money management allows you to do. So here's what I want to do. I want to give you, now that you've got your money freed up, I want to give you 10 ways that Tammy and I have found to make it rain and have fun with our money. The first way is this. Now that we have the excess funds in our life, we're able to give like we've always wanted to give. I'm telling you what, we have been able to give so much money over the years. And if you'd have told this 10, 15, 20 years ago, you told us that we were able to give this amount of money, we'd have laughed. But now that we have good money management that's under our control, we're able to give like we always wanted to give. And at the end of every year, we decide who we want to give to, ministries we want to give to for the next year. And then I always have freed up funds throughout the year to give as needs arise. So number one is we get to give like we always want to give. The second way we make it rain is pay our monthly expenses and we don't worry about it. If you're married, fellas, if you're married and you have a wife, I'm telling you, one of the deepest needs of women is to know that they're being provided for. You can create so much peace in your family life if you simply will handle your money correctly and then be able to pay off your expenses and not have to worry about it. How would you like that? I tell you what, it is a great peace of mind. Way number three is this. We pay for our kids' passions and have the freedom to be present. You know, our son grew up playing baseball. He's still playing baseball in college. And our daughter grew up dancing and competitive dancing. And we've been all over the country traveling with both of them, being able to provide for their needs and lessons and games and all kinds of stuff. And it hasn't been a burden on our life. It's been a joy on our life. So that's another way that we make it rain. The fourth way that we make it rain is we save up for and we've been able to pay for our kids' college education. I tell you what, we are in the most expensive time in our lives right now because both of our kids are in college. But here's the cool thing. We've not only saved up, but we can pay for that and not have to worry about it. Our goal is for them to get out of college so that they don't have student loan debt and they can have a good start with their life. Way number five is we save up for our retirement. Pretty simple. We're excited about it. It gives us a peace of mind. Way number six, we are always prepared for opportunities. Listen to this one closely. If you can handle your money appropriately and start having excess funds, you can be prepared for opportunities when they arise. You know, a lot of people, you know, sit back when opportunities arise and they know that they can't take advantage of them and they wish they would have changed things in the past. I'm telling you right now, change things now so that in the future, you're prepared for opportunities. We were prepared to purchase the lake home that we have, a great opportunity at the right time, and we were able to jump on it. We were able to purchase a business just a few weeks ago because we were prepared for that. And it arose and we took advantage of it. We've had several investment opportunities that have arisen over the years that we've been able to take advantage of, but we wouldn't have been able to do that if we didn't have our money under control. Way number seven, the freedom to take care of the needs that come up. There are several different needs that come up when we have the freedom to be able to take care of them. For instance, a couple of years ago, my folks were living out in Oregon on the coast out there, and they wanted to move back to Nebraska, so we were able to help them find a home and all that. But my dad had a truck and a boat and some things that they wanted to travel out here, back here with. And so I was able to take just a full week off, go out there, enjoy the coast for probably the last time with them in that setting, and then be able to drive the truck and the boat back with my dad. Just a cherished moment that I'll never forget, and so thankful that I had the freedom to be able to do that. Way number eight, deeply invest in ourselves for professional and personal growth. I think it's so important to invest in yourself. And Tammy and I have been able to do that. And I tell you what, there are some great opportunities out there that cost money, but provide exclusive pay dividends because you're investing in yourself. And opportunities that you wouldn't normally have, networking and getting to know other people that you wouldn't get to know otherwise, that can help you continue to grow and to develop. So it's a great way to be able to make it rain. How about number nine? Enjoy fun vacations with the family and make memories. We've been able to enjoy ourselves. We've been able to travel from coast to coast, travel to Jamaica and go to Atlantis and have a great time with the kids. We just got back from an incredible trip to Florida, making incredible memories with our family and being able to make it rain for that whole time. It's just so fun. And then way number 10 is that we've been able to enjoy recreation and passions and the dreams on our heart. The finances have allowed us to live out things that we wouldn't normally live out. So many great things. And the cool part about this is this. We've been able to bring other people along, pay for certain experiences and opportunities that other people wouldn't have had if we wouldn't have managed our money well. And when you get to do that and serve other people in that way, it is so fulfilling. So I hope and that you're blessed in this way. I hope that you take advantage of these principles and apply them in your life and experience the same blessings that we've experienced as well. Now, my challenge is simple. Once you've eliminated your debt, it's time to find a good investment professional who will honestly help you grow and steward your wealth that God has given you to make it rain. And then I want you to double down on your freedom of income and put it to work. All right. I'd love to hear what you think about this this episode. Simply put it in the chat area below. Please give us some thumbs up, some hearts. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and share this with those that you care about. I'm Doug Fitzgerald. Remember, you only have one shot at your amazing one life. So go out there and make every single day count. I'll see you next time.